Alright, color, it's color's turn. Alright.
Take a second and say the look on your face as you guys walked up here,
it was amazing.
You know, it sort of took me back. Today's an exciting and memorable day. I still remember my graduation day. Yeah, it was a long time ago. You know, but it's a rite of passage, and to me, it was the signaling of the beginning of my adult life. When I was asked to do this speech, the first question I said, why me? Then after thinking about it, I realized that what I have to say here will be likely memorialized on YouTube or Snapchat. Then I got scared. My father had just one requirement for me to go to college, and that it had to be greater than 100 miles away from me. The reason for that is I would not show up on the weekends with my laundry. My high school teacher who inspired me was Mrs. Anita Tompkins. At the time, she was my high school chemistry teacher, and I took probably what is becoming AP chemistry, because I was way through my first year. After graduating from UNR, I reached for the stars. And I did my residency at Washington University in St. Louis, which at the time was considered one of the top programs in the United States. I knew no one in St. Louis, but I wanted the best training that I could get, so I moved, and I went for it. Now, I wasn't totally alone, because my wife, or soon-to-be wife, and savior, more on that to come, I had met her in Reno in medical school. She followed me to St. Louis, but not without the Reno. And this was 30 years before Beyonce, so. If I thought medical school was fun, and it was, I'd do it all again. If I had a chance, man, I'd be in there. I'd do it again in other people. But residency, now that was a whole different beast. Back,
she's also an avid reader and gardener. Please join me for welcoming Ms. Kazaskis. Experience. And without your patience, support, and love, our graduates would have had
one more round of applause for our Coral Academy teachers. Of teamwork and the value. value of sacrificing to achieve your goals. You've learned how vital it is to respect your fellow classmates, to follow directions, and the importance of giving back and making a positive difference in your world. These are lessons that will help you succeed long after you've left Coral Academy. And now I'm going to level with you a little bit, and I'm talking especially to our graduates. It's true that your time here has given you an excellent educational experience and a set of powerful tools. But I'm going to challenge you with a question. What will you do with everything you've been given? What will you do to leave your mark on the community? What will your community, your neighborhood, your state, your country remember you for? As you think about this next chapter of your life, what do you want it to say about you? Because it's not enough just to know how to get the right answer, and it's not enough to have the right tools for the job. Each of you has a responsibility to use everything you've been given to try to make a difference in the world around you. It's going to be up to you to use what you've been given, to apply everything you've learned, not only to shape your own life, but to shape the future of your community. And you've got to remember that learning is a lifelong process. It doesn't end when you graduate high school, or college, or graduate school. As you move on in your academic and professional careers and reach new milestones in your lives, I hope you'll continue to build on the foundation that you've helped establish here, the example that you've set here at Coral Academy. While today marks the culmination of a lot of hard work, I know today is also just the beginning and the first of many successes ahead for each and every one of you. As you leave high school, you're about to become members, the newest members of a global economy that's increasingly interconnected, competitive, and as challenging as it has ever been. Whether you're moving on to higher education or embarking on a career, you've got your work cut out for you. And the reality is it's not always going to be easy. You've got big issues to tackle, and there are going to be days when you just feel like throwing in the towel. But you know something? And I'm speaking not just for myself, but for your teachers, your counselors, your coaches, and your loved ones when I say, we believe in you. We have total confidence that each one of you is ready for the challenges ahead. Each one of you knows how to give 110%, how to work together for a cause that is greater than any one person, and how to keep going until the job is done. And if you'll stay committed to those values that you've learned here at Coral Academy, I know that whatever comes your way, you'll be ready to take it head on, to embrace new challenges and explore new opportunities. You'll be ready to accomplish great things for yourselves, and more importantly, to impact the lives of those around you. So looking out at the faces of our graduates, I know Nevada's future is bright, because the leaders, inventors, and entrepreneurs, and innovators of tomorrow are right here in this room. And I know each of you are ready to take that next step and go out and change the world. Thank you once again for the chance, the privilege to celebrate with you, and once again, congratulations, class of 2019.
Hello, my fellow graduates, friends, parents, and teachers. Thank you all for coming here today to celebrate the next chapter of our lives and for all of your support and encouragement up until this point. Some of you may believe that our journeys are just now beginning, but I believe that our journey started a long time ago. And with the help of all of you, we have gotten to this point where the path that we've all been traveling together for so long will divide into 89 unique ones. Along the way, despite how prepared or planned we are, we will all face forks in the road, be stuck at crossroads, encounter the unexpected, and take wrong turns. Sometimes, it isn't so easy to be present when our paths face us with so many errors and decisions pointing every which way. But when we stop to take a look around and appreciate how far we have come, we can find solace and confidence in the decisions we've yet to make. Thank you all for giving me the best start I could have asked for. I hope one day my path will be able to cross with each and every one of yours again. Now, we have all helped me welcome our student body representative speaker, Ezra Idoju, to the podium.
You know, I remember back in the day watching President Obama speaking on TV. I really admired his speaking style and wondered if I could one day be like him. My 10-year-old self sat there thinking about how I could be more like Barack Obama. As he once stated, quote, "I'm not the strapping young Muslim socialist that I used to be," end quote. And I thought to myself, man, we really do have something in common. Except I soon found out that I'm not a socialist, and Obama is not a Muslim. Now, we may not have that many similarities, but I will still attempt to motivate and persuade just like him. I can't believe that I just compared myself to such an amazing speaker. What an abomination. I would first like to thank my friends, family, classmates, teachers, and everyone who has helped me get to where I am today. But more importantly, everyone who has put up with my terrible bachelor discussion with Mr. Winther in our AP literature class, our beautiful roasting sessions, including Kyle's love life, and we can't forget about Cheyenne's delightfully cold mixtape. Now, we've been through some tough times together, enjoying those delightful steak nuggets at the Outback Steakhouse during the senior trip. Some honorable mentions go out to Jason Lynn for just being Jason Lynn, and also Bailey's beautiful, captivating fan fictions. Each of these memories will stay with us for the years to come, and I'm grateful to be a part of such an interesting class. These individuals standing right behind me have truly become my second family. My teachers have become my mentors, my therapists, my role models. Education I have received from you all in the past 4 years is something that has changed the way I see the world, something that has changed the way I see the world around me, something that I will forever take with me. At a time where I had no confidence in myself, where I felt tiny and helpless in this big world, you helped me find my voice. You have given me the strength and courage to be able to be up here today, something that I would have never been able to do just 4 years ago. You have taught us to speak up for ourselves and for others, to stand up for what's right and bring change to this cruel world. As I stand up here today, I can tell you that we will not let any of you down. To all of our teachers, thank you. We are so grateful to have such strong, encouraging individuals that have helped us, changed us in ways that we could have never even imagined. We will take advantage of all of the opportunities each of you have given us. Every day, as I look around my class, I see the talent, passion, dedication each student holds. I am truly honored to be graduating alongside these individuals. Behind me today, you are looking at the future innovators, writers, physicists, artists, leaders, the eager, creative minds that are about to be set free. I am oh so confident in what the future holds for us. Now, I would like to invite the speaker on behalf of the valedictorians, Zachary Hammer.
Humility, navigate obstacles, and experience limitations of this mindset. nights, early mornings, making sure I got my projects done, and always seeming to know exactly what to say when I needed the most. And to my sister Brooke, thank you for always being my biggest cheerleader. I love you guys so much. You have made me the man that I want to be. Falcon Nation, even though our paths may diverge at this point, I'm saying so thankful to have spent these last 4 years, or in some cases 10 years, with you. And I take comfort in knowing that we will always be connected as a Falcon family. William Butler Yeats once said, "Education is not the filling of a pail, but the burning of a fire." Coral Academy has given us the tinder and match. Now it's up to us to light that fire and burn, follow our passions, and always soar to excellence. Thank you.
Thank you, students, for those reflective and moving words. Seniors of the class of 2019, it can be said that these are the best years of your life, or that perhaps as you embark on your next adventures in higher learning, those will be the best days in your life. But if I may be honest with you, the best days in your life are for you to choose. When you leave here, I want you to remember those words of Lloyd Anderson, who said, "We learn more by looking for the answer to a question and not finding it than we do from learning from the answer itself." And so I challenge you to never satiate that desire for looking for answers, to seek them out and uncover every stone of opportunity and topple over every barricade to your enlightenment. I challenge you to look at yourself every day through the eyes of a child, unfettered and without prejudice, to be able to better understand that this journey will never end and that the destination has little to do with the trip itself. Ahab himself knew this to be true when Melville wrote, "It is not down to any map, true places never are." Find those places that have never been mapped. Become the cartographers of the next generation. And above all else, be happy and make yourselves proud. I am honored to have had you as students and will greatly miss your energy on campus. Wherever your paths take you, walk it proudly. And now for the moment we've all been waiting for, we will now begin the presentation of the diplomas. Mr. Executive Director and Ms. Board Secretary, upon review of the academic progress of the aforementioned students, it has been determined by the administration of Coral Academy of Science that these students have satisfactorily met all of the standards necessary for high school graduation as set forth by the state of Nevada. It is my pleasure as Assistant Principal of Coral Academy of Science, Las Vegas, to present you the senior class of 2019.
Rostia. Vanessa Blaschick. Jack Bryan. Cooper Berkey.
Savannah James Hicks.
Jamie Twee Hughes. Safira Ibrahim. Brianna Jimenez. Mason Jonah. Jackson John Randall Barr. AJ Marker. Thank you.
Tatiana Sclafani. Nabil Shah. Nicholas Sharma.
It is now time to conclude our ceremony with the changing of the tassels. The changing of the tassel symbolizes one's transition from candidate to graduate. Seniors, please move your tassels from right to left.